The samba that I'm going to demonstrate was made popular by drummers like Steve Gadd. It's a little bit different than the actual Brazilian samba. Most of the time when you're playing the drum set, if someone asks you to play a samba, you're going to be playing with jazz musicians. You might be playing in a big band, a stage band. And really what they want to hear is the kind of drum set version, I guess, of the samba, not necessarily an authentic Brazilian samba. So anyway, that's what we're going to concern ourselves with today. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a little demonstration here again to show you what it's supposed to sound like, and then we'll talk about how to develop this, what all's involved. It took me a long time to learn how to play this, but it's one of my favorite things to play actually now. So from this angle, you should be able to see what I'm doing a little better here. First thing, this bass drum goes like this. One, a two, a three, a four, a one, a two, a three, a four, a one. Then you add the hi-hat on the offbeats, on the and. So it sounds like this. One. Next thing I did is I practiced in the beginning out of George Lawrence Stone's Stick Control, that particular book. And if you start on the first page, there's a bunch of sticking patterns, single strokes, double strokes, and then a bunch of paradiddle inversions. And you just practice those over the top of this to develop some basic independence. So the first one. Everything lines up perfectly. That's number two. Three, I'm not sure anyway, but paradiddles. So on. Then put your right hand over on the rim, your right drumstick, and do the same thing. Paradiddles. Went through a lot of books practicing like this, different things over the samba to develop the independence. There's a book by Gary Chaffee called Patterns, a bunch of accent patterns. Eventually you can put some double strokes in there. Eventually, you'll speed that up. Eventually, you'll learn to improvise over that and play various things. Thank you. I do is I think of one pattern, like da 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 da, and I'm doing that with my right hand. And sometimes the left hand plays some of those notes along with that right hand pattern, or sometimes it puts some in between. And basically, you think of one overall rhythm, like da 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 da. Practice those rhythms initially on the snare drum and the rim of the snare, and then move it up to the ride cymbal. You're going to have basically the same thing. It's the same coordination. It's just going to sound a little different. That's the basic idea. Now, one thing I want to mention is when I was first learning to play the samba, I would practice ostinatos with the right hand. Because some of the books at the time I was studying out of, that's what they that was how they handled the samba, basically. So I'd play things like this, like, let's see. And various things with the left hand. And basically what I found is that was very limiting, at least for me. I met a drummer from Puerto Rico when I was in the military, and he was watching me practice the samba one day in the practice room, and I asked him what he thought, and he said, I needed to loosen up more. He said, instead of being so rigid with it, he said, just loosen up. And so that's when I started playing more of an interactive rhythm between the two hands, and that's what I've done ever since, and it works really well, at least for me. I think that's really how most drummers play it, again, like more like this. Takes a lot of practice. It's a lot of fun to improvise over once you really get it down. For me, it took a long time. Some of my students, it didn't take quite as long. Hopefully, I pointed them in the right direction. So hopefully, if you practice exactly the way I showed you today, it won't take you near as long as it did for me to master it. And again, it's a lot of fun. It's well worth the effort. So, good luck.